We have to keep the trommel going in order to reach our 5,000-ounce goal. It's not optional. We have to stick to it.
Klondike King, Tony Beets, is digging deeper than ever before, opening up two monster cuts in the hunt for Paradise Hill's gold-rich White Channel pay streak.
The Gold Cup and the Blue Cups are going to be key out this season. It's been a while since we did them that big. I think they should easily produce 2,500 apiece. They're going to have to deliver.
After 5 weeks fighting deep frozen ground in both his cuts, Tony's banked less than 500 ounces, way short of the 200 ounces a week he needs.
I'm going to be here ripping in here for a good chunk of the day, probably a good chunk of tomorrow, because frozen pay is just a pain in the ass.
Tony's entrusted youngest son, Mike, with managing the cuts and bringing in the gold.
Mike, he has a big responsibility this year. He has to have enough material there in order to keep the sluice box going. But the ground being that frozen, he's got to rip it with two cuts. He really has his job cut out.
A mechanical balancing act, Mike must juggle the 9-acre cold cut with its foreboding 60-foot deep frozen pay layer, alongside the newly opened 6-acre blue cut, where D11 dozers use ripper shanks to expose stubborn permafrost to sunlight. If it doesn't defrost in time, the stockpile of thawed pay dirt will run out, forcing them to shut down.
Getting this all ripped up, so it all thaws out and we have a lot of pay ready to
sluice then.
The only other machine in Tony's arsenal powerful enough to dig through frozen pay is the $1.1 million 950 excavator. Mike has tasked James Rhino, a Beets crew veteran, with digging out the pay, ready to thaw at the pay pile.
It's pretty frosty in here this morning. A lot of frozen ground in here. Hey, Tony, you copy?
James, go ahead.
Yeah, this ground is really hard. Can we come up with another plan?
Throw the thing out of there,
bring it to the staging yard, and we'll figure something out.
Okay.
We're gonna take the boom off the excavator. We're gonna put a shorter boom on, and then we have more power and it's easy to get a bucket full. This should be a lot more productive.
Tony's plan is to remove the 950's 28-foot boom and replace it with a 24-foot boom. The shorter arm will generate more force and concentrate digging power.
We already took the stick and the bucket off. Now we're gonna pull the main boom pin out.
Taking charge of the swap is mechanic Sam Aftenis.
The pin stuck in here. It's just being up.
What do you got, Sam?
So, I foresee pulling that pin out is gonna be a pain in the ass.
Says who?
Me.
James.
Yep.
Double wrap that half-inch chain around one of those uprights.
Around one of them?
Double wrap it. Good. Hook it up, wrap it up.
It's not gonna work with the slip hook, is it?
Oh, really? What if you double wrap it, it does?
.54½, and that is 5. I'm hoping that pin doesn't jump out of there, frig.
No, that's why he's pulling with the bucket, not the loader.
Okay.
Throw your bucket a bit. Pull it.
Oh. That's sweet.
Oh no, I hooked it up, remember?
Yeah, I do.
You ready for the boom?
Yeah.
Good, go for it. Just put it on the ground, who cares? We got the boom off, now put this one on, and then we'll see how far we're gonna get today. Okay, lift it up. Let's go hook it up.
Whoa.
Put some good pressure on it. Put.
Wait. James, what's my cab? What's the paint? Hang in there for a second, Sam.
Okay,
have a bit. James, push it over a bit. Put the in.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, somebody on there, bingo.
Takes over when it's easy. We're in the other side.
Okay, take her off. Good luck.
That went really well. Yeah.
That went nice.
That was pretty slick.
Nice.
Woo!
With the 950 back in the blue coat.
My old girl, I gotta get her back in the dirt.
It should tear through the concrete hard frozen ground and keep the trommel fed with thawed pay dirt.
Well, it does dig a lot better than that long boom. Just tears through that frost. Nice full scoops. It actually picks the bucket up, so that's a nice change. It's gonna be a little bit different getting used to having trucks closer to you because you're gonna have to keep them nice and tight to be able to reach them, but I like the way it digs. We're gonna have a lot better time keeping up with trucks and moving a lot more dirt with this thing.
Oh, you've got the ugly face!
After a week battling frozen ground, the Beets family gather to find out if their hard work has paid off.
My face.
Oh, that's it.
Took long enough. Sorry.
Anyway, so another go away.
Yes.
Yep. So guess what? It came out of both cuts.
Both cuts.
A lot of frost, though.
Yeah. Real hard too.
I was 11. That rips that stuff nice though, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, if you didn't buy that last year, we'd be in big trouble this year.
So, anything else exciting happened?
Ruby was trying to squeeze by Cousin Mike in a rock truck. It wasn't quite enough room.
Well, I bet she felt just awful though.
Oh, she did. Just.
Oh. At least he cares.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, it could have been a lot worse. So it was good.
Oh, yeah.
So. With that being said, we should probably pour some gold.
Yeah.
Okay, let's do this thing, folks.
Tony has less than 500 ounces in the bank and needs over 200 a week to hit his 5,000 ounce goal.
3, 2, 1, let's go.
15. $162.42.
Worth nearly $300,000.
That's a little less than normal, but I guess with the material that we had, let's have to make up for the next time, I guess.
But you know what? It's better than nothing.
Better than a roll.
Yeah.
Sluicing every day. Anyway, that ripping goes is good. But you're going to have to stay ahead with that in order to keep sluicing, don't we? Okay, good enough. Okay, get the out then.
We'll talk to you guys later.